Good evening, Joe, and hail the Flashlight King.
Well, hail you, sir.
As a recent return listener to your show, I must say that it is good to hear some good old back and forth between you all. I recently found my way back to you in the search of finding alternative voices to the common narrative that we can find ourselves exposed to in our own little silos of information. I consider myself a well-stoned liberal type, if you will, for context. As I was scanning the internet this evening, I came across this article from an admittedly conservative entity. It is now apparently clear we are losing our way as the play Grease is too sexist to be performed in schools. These are the types of things that divide us. This ridiculous interpretation of morality is toxic on both extremes. I would be fascinated to hear your take on this befuddling, outrageous, and sad commentary in the state of our country. Keep up the battle, a liberal lion, tongue-in-cheek. Chris Thomas in New Brighton. And what he linked me to was, I think it's a story from The Hill. Is The Hill a conservative news site, John?
Yes.
I don't think it's conservative. I think it's pretty well balanced, isn't it?
Well, it's a story out of Australia where we learned two Australian private schools have halted their planned joint production of the musical Grease after students protested against it, calling the show sexist and anti-feminist. Some parents have complained that the school's decision is only a small minority found it offensive. Actress Olivia Newton-John, who stars in the movie Grease, said last year that there's nothing sexist about the film and it's just a movie and it shouldn't be taken too seriously. That's the problem. People take minor things too seriously.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Two private schools. I did that part, didn't I, already?
Johnny, you're right. It's an American newspaper and digital media company based in D.C., but it does not say it's conservative.
It was actually started by a New York Times reporter.
Jerry Finkelstein and Martin Tolkien.
Students at two K-12 schools in Perth, Presbyterian Ladies College and Scotch College, reportedly protested against the school's planned joint production of Grease, claiming the musical was offensive, sexist, and anti-feminist, the local newspaper The West Australian reported. The students also called on the schools to ban future productions of the show. The schools have not announced which show will replace Grease. This isn't the first time Grease has been accused of being anti-feminist, and viewers in recent years have said it promotes a questionable representation of women. In the movie rendition, Sandy, played by Olivia Newton-John, wears skin-tight black clothes to win back Danny, played by John Travolta.
Yeah, she did.
Although Danny also changes his look for Sandy by putting on a Letterman sweater. Some say it's sexist because Sandy is the one who vastly changes her appearance. See, who cares? I don't. Olivia Newton-John has dispelled those claims and told The Guardian last year it's a movie. It's a story from the 50s.
Get over it.
Yeah. Everyone forgets it at the end. He changes for her, too, she added. There's nothing deep in there about the Me Too movement. It's a sorry state of affairs that these kids are that stupid, that they're that unimaginative. What future do they imagine? What kind of production of Grease could they possibly tolerate?
Or have to get rid of 80% of the movies and plays that are written, if
or
that's
the fact
your basis.
That anybody's going to give it more than 2 seconds of thought after it's over, you know.
And Grease, if I'm not mistaken, doesn't that go back to Broadway?
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah. A long time ago, right?
Yeah, that's for sure.
I mean, West Side Story obviously has to be gone.
I want to live in America.
I know you do. I know you do.
I really can't do anything because all my earworm right now is, I got chills, they're multiplying, and I'm losing control. 'Cause the